Let me start?
Yeah, go ahead.
Welcome to Branscomb Memorial Auditorium. I am Dr. Pamela Dykes, and I will be your MNC for tonight's celebration of Black jazz composers. This Black History Month performance, directed by Dr. Jeffrey Benatar, will be performed by the Florida Southern College Jazz Program in cooperation with Florida Southern's Jazz Education Network, University Chapter, and FSC's Music Department. We are also honored to be streaming this through the Florida Southern College's main YouTube page. This three-part program will feature the Chamber Jazz Ensemble, the Jazz Workshop Ensemble, and FSC's Big Band, and the Florida Southern College Jazz Ensemble. All sections are composed and are arranged by some of the most influential Black jazz composers from the past and the present. We encourage you to clap after each soloist, in addition and after each piece. Please welcome to the stage the Florida Southern College Jazz Ensemble. Wayne Shorter grew to prominence as the musical director and saxophonist with Art Blakey and the Jazz Messengers from 1959 to 1963, one of the most important hard bop ensembles in the jazz tradition. In 1963, he replaced John Coltrane and George Coleman as the saxophonist in Miles Davis' famous second quintet. After leaving Davis in the 1970s, he teamed up with keyboardist Joe Zawinul and co-led the Weather Report, one of the pioneering fusion bands. Shorter has received more than 10 Grammy Awards, including the Lifetime Achievement Award in 2015, and was named the Jazz Master by the National Endowment for the Arts in 1998, and was a Kennedy Center honoree in 2018. During this pandemic, he has written an opera and with Esperanza Spalding. The Chamber Jazz Ensemble will now perform Children of the Night by Wayne Shorter, which was originally released in the album Mosaic and Art Blakey with the Jazz Messengers in 1961. This version was transcribed for us by Christopher Ring, the trombonist in the ensemble. Thank you. This next piece also comes from the Library of Art Blakely and the Jazz Messengers from this time from one of our former pianists, Bobby Timmons. Like many jazz musicians in the traditions, Timmons cut his teeth in Philadelphia, developing his funky bluesy style before moving on to New York City in the 1950s. This piece is Dat Dare, also transcribed by Christopher Ring.
Thank you.
McCoy Tyner was most well known for his association with saxophonist John Coltrane and his classic quartet with Jimmy Garrison, on bass Elvin Jones on the drums in the early 1960s. This is perhaps Tyner's most well-known composition, arranged by our drummer, Travis Sensabaugh, Passion Dance. As the oldest of three musical brothers, Hank, Thad, and Elvin, Hank Jones was mostly known as a sideman. He was a staff pianist for CBS Studios, was on tour for several years with the Jazz at the Philharmonic All-Star Small Group run by Norman Granz, and played with the All-Stars like Cannonball Adderley and Miles Davis, and modern-day legends like Joe Lovano, Dave Holland, Billy Higgins, and others. This is Jones' beautiful ballad, arranged by Dr. Benatar, Angel Face. Thank you. Back to another living legend, saxophonist Sonny Rollins. Rollins, also a Kennedy Center Award honoree, recorded with legends like Miles Davis and Charlie Parker and Thelonious Monk in the 50s, and continued to play for the next 70 years. One of his most iconic pieces, St. Thomas, was arranged for this ensemble by Christopher King. Thank you. Marsalis Jr. is one of the most important names in jazz education. From New Orleans, Marsalis and his four musical sons, who all still play, Winton, Branford, Jason, and Delphio, from the Marsalis family, a jazz celebration album featuring all five Marsalis musicians. The Chamber Jazz Ensemble will close this first part with Swingin' at Heaven, transcribed by Christopher Ring. Southern College Chamber Jazz Ensemble. Please welcome to the stage our second act, the Florida Southern College Jazz Workshop Ensemble. Today we move now to perhaps the most prolific writing duo in the history of American music, Duke Ellington and Billy Strayhorn. Duke Ellington, one of the most important leaders of big band music, got his first break as he moved his group to the Washingtonians to New York City and held residency at the Cotton Club. The club was where black musicians, dancers, and artists performed for white audiences. This racist environment, however, allowed for Ellington to develop his own personal style, arranging specifically for the talented musicians in his band. Strayhorn was invited by Ellington to join him as his writing partner in 1939. With directions to get Ellington's house, Strayhorn wrote, "Take a Train." This piece later became a hit that became Duke Ellington's orchestra's theme song. Here is Take the Train, as arranged by Dr. Benatar.
Thank you.
This next and final piece by the workshop ensemble is Horace Silver's Song for My Father. An originator of hip hard bop and founding member of the Jazz Messengers before Art Blakely took over, this piece is a little track from 1965 album that was inspired by Silver's Brazilian travels. Enjoy, Song for My Father, arranged by Dr. Benatar. How about another hand for the Florida Southern College Jazz Workshop Ensemble. Please welcome to the stage the Florida Southern College Jazz Ensemble. Next, we move to a piece co-composed by saxophonist Shafi Hadi and one of the most underappreciated jazz musicians of the 20th century, Mary Lou Williams. Williams was a superb pianist, arranger, and composer. One of the most well-known orchestra works is Zodiac Suite. She arranged this piece to feature the alto saxophone. Hope you enjoy, Shafi.
Thank you.
That was actually Shiny Stockings by Frank Foster. Now we will move to Shafi by Shafi, Hadi, and Mary Lou Williams. After leaving the Count Basie Orchestra and freelancing for a number of years, trumpeter and cornetist Thad Jones, a younger brother of Hank Jones we heard from earlier, formed with the drummer Mel Lewis the Thad Jones Mel Lewis Orchestra. This orchestra has continued performing even after both Thad Jones and Mel Lewis passed away. It is now known as the Vanguard Jazz Orchestra, which plays every Monday night in Greenwich Village's famous club, the Village Vanguard. Please enjoy this first piece by us, followed by Kids Are Pretty People.
Thank you.
This 21st century composition by Grammy Award-winning bassist, composer, and arranger, Christian McBride. Since 2016, he has served as the artistic director of the Newport Jazz Festival and regularly plays with both his own ensembles and the legends from the past. Please enjoy Brother Mister. Thank you. We'd like to leave you with a final composition by a couple of the creators of the modern jazz in the 1940s, sometimes called bebop, and created at Milton's Playhouse Jam Sessions in New York City. Thelonious Monk had his own distinct percussive piano sound. Saxophonist Coleman Hawkins was always hiring younger musicians to push himself and co-write this piece with Monk. Enjoy, I Mean You. Another hand for the Florida Southern College Jazz Ensemble. Thank you again for joining us through this celebration of Black jazz composers. A special thanks to Joe Bowe and Crystal Norman. I am Dr. Pamela Dykes, and I would like to say goodnight. Thank you all for coming.